To be honest with you, this is one of the very few cases where instead of me saying I didn't want to make a video like this, I say that I want to make a video like this. Things like this need to be addressed and outed once and for all, because behaviors and actions like we are going to be talking about here in this video is 100% objective toxicity and unhealthy and unwelcome in any community. So, you all are wondering what this is about? Well, let me give you a brief recap. So recently, there has been a huge outcry in the speaking out movement where various individuals have shared rather uncomfortable stories involving things like rape, sexual assault, etc. Pretty much some of the worst things ranked on the list of what never ever to do to another person. Last year, a multitude of people within the Pokemon community have come out with their own stories regarding sharing extremely uncomfortable and sad stories. One of those individuals is Felicity. She had shared a very emotional story regarding her experiences involving being preyed upon by an adult male known as Decatur when she was at the time 15 years old. Now let us fast forward to the present time. An individual by the name of Jubilee Blaze has decided to reemerge and cause more controversy. For those of you guys that don't know who Jubilee Blaze is, she is a content creator who claims to be a feminist, but exhibits behavior that even real feminists would disavow. Rather than trying to give you all a history lesson that would extend this video 20 minutes longer than needed, I will instead link you guys to a Twitter thread made by the user PhillyBeatsYou that has documented everything about this person and her controversies in the past. This will give you a good idea of who we are dealing with here. Now, these screenshots we are going to be seeing here are what is left as Jubilee no longer has Twitter. Gee, I wonder why. So I will be linking all of the receipts in the description below so you can see all of these for yourself. Jubilee decided to take Felicity's story and weaponize it in an attempt to slander a group of YouTubers who at one point in the past, prior to the Decatur incident, had associated with him. Now these gentlemen were 100% unaware of what Decatur was doing behind the scenes, and the moment they found out, they severed ties with him because they completely disavow predatory behavior. Jubilee, however, decided to use this despite them being 100% innocent and attempted to slander them by weaponizing Felicity's story. Why? Well, unless you are someone who has a warped mindset like Jubilee, who knows why? As a result, Felicity had sensitive wounds reopened and she had to relive the trauma she experienced, all thanks to Jubilee's dumbass. I had spoken to Felicity in private messages, and without going into extreme details, she was very hurt in all of this. My heart broke for her, and I felt a great deal of pity for her. No one should ever have to have their story used as a weapon to maliciously slander and libel others who are 100% innocent. Now that's just one half of the problem. Let us fast forward to MNJ TV, who is the boyfriend of Jubilee and a massive cuck at that, has actually aided and abetted Jubilee's slanderous behavior. I get wanting to support loved ones and stuff, but Jesus Christ, man, if something is objectively and factually wrong, you need to speak up and stop things from getting worse. Instead, your balls are in your lady's purse. Anyways, he then puts out not one, but two attempts at an apology. Right off the bat, you can see there is a lot wrong here, because this just comes off as completely disingenuous, because why delete your first apology? Well, let us read off the first apology, shall we? This statement is a joint one from both Jubilee and myself. She has deactivated her Twitter, and that is the reason why she hasn't said anything so far. We are sorry this has taken some time to post. We wanted to take time to gather our thoughts and emotions in order to present this correctly. Jubilee's tweets and my retweets of them yesterday were hurtful to two parties. The first party is Felicity. The tweets caused her to relive her trauma, and that was the last thing Jubilee intended. I've spoken privately to Felicity and apologized, but we wanted to publicly apologize as well. She should have been consulted prior to any public discussion about what she experienced. That mistake is one that Jubilee and I, for retweeting, regret. We are extremely sorry to have caused her more pain. The second party is Vinny, Dylan, Ryan, and Frank. The events that unfolded at PAX East 2019 were very unpleasant for many people, and the complicated multi-party nature of what occurred resulted in miscommunications about who knew what at what point. While we disagree with how some things were handled in the immediate hours after knowledge became public, those disagreements should have been handled privately. Before the end of the day, though, they did the right thing and cut Nathan out. Jubilee's tweets inadvertently misconstrued what happened and what exactly we took issue with, and it painted them with too broad a brush. I would say they should have been worded more carefully, but as I mentioned, they should not have been posted at all. I can't imagine the pain of discovering someone you're close to is actually vile, and the tweets posted caused them to relive that experience. We regret that and are sorry we caused them emotional distress. I hope to have a chance to speak privately with them in order to sort everything out and move on. We never intended for this to be a targeted attack or slander or anything like that. Jubilee made an impulsive and emotional decision that she regrets and is sorry for, and I am sorry for sharing them. Okay, well, I definitely can see why this wasn't well received. This is more of him trying to defend and justify her actions, especially when you factor in the wording here. When you use words like inadvertently misconstrued, that is a cop-out. There is nothing to misconstrue about being slandered over pedophilia accusations or being guilty by association. So as a result of that, he deleted that and came out with a quote, new and improved apology post, and honestly, actions speak a ton louder than words, my guy. You and your girlfriend caused deep damage, not just to a group of innocent people who had nothing to do with supporting a pedophile like Decatur, but more than that, you caused a victim of being preyed upon by a predator to relive her worst nightmares. Whether you like to think or admit to it or not, you both caused damage and put scars in place that may not heal. It also doesn't help the fact that MNJTV is a massive figure in the Pokemon community with over 1 million subscribers and his girlfriend having over 100,000 subscribers. This is a couple with a lot of power that is an extreme example of the wrong people in the position of said power. As someone who has had experience in dealing with Jubilee in the past, I can say 100% she is not a good person. She has a messiah complex and thinks that she can do absolutely no wrong, and if you point it out, then you're doing this because she's a girl, and she will treat you like that last bit of spinach on your plate that your parents tell you to eat. She completely blocks out any criticisms and will mislabel it as harassment. As for MNJTV, I do not support him at all, especially now. I will also say that I did not appreciate you trying to go at my friend Manga Common, who made a video being fair and critical of your girlfriend's behavior back in 2019 when she made her Girls in Gaming rant video that was objectively and factually flawed. Now, rather than going back and trying to break down what happened, I will instead link you guys to a video that Manga did on this subject, and he does a very good job. I got blocked by Jubilee all because I refused to be a white knight and attack my own friend over his video, even though she referred to him as human garbage. Sorry, sweetheart, I'm nobody's white knight. To the both of you, the community is better off without you. Unless you two go through some serious mental health and therapy, your behaviors and personalities are not welcomed at all. End of. Now that was going to be the end of the video, but as of me recording and editing this, there's actually a bit of a development here. Jubilee has since reinstated her Twitter and come out with a written apology. Now between her and MNJTV, this is their third attempt at an apology, And it as well comes off as completely disingenuous and forced, and not to mention very much incomplete as well, as it doesn't even begin to scratch the surface of what they need to be held accountable for. And also, Jubilee, where is Fanatec's apology? He deserves an apology too. Why is he left out of your written twit-longer apology? Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be it here for the video. I hope I don't have to make another, because honestly, when it comes to toxic individuals like Jubilee and MNJTV, they don't deserve to have any spotlight or attention on them. So unless something crazy, crazy, crazy big happens, this is going to be my only video on this matter. Thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate your guys' support and taking time out of your day to hear me out and watch this video. You guys are legends. Don't y'all ever forget it. I love you guys. Thank you again. I'll see you in the next one.